Hello everyone, I'm Greyclock, thank you for joining me, and welcome back to Factorio, a single rocket. So, between episodes, I just realized we don't really need to set this up. We have robots to do that for us, as we can now create request adjust, so we can get logistic robots to do all of our resource hauling for us. So let's not do this here. And let's prepare an area where we can have robots do stuff for us. And actually, we don't need rails here either. I mean, we don't really need to let the robots do stuff for us, but it's just so much easier to organize stuff if we do it that way. Oh no, no more inventory space. What is filling up my inventory? Junk, of course. So more junk chests. That should do it for now, I guess. So first of all, we're going to collect all of our resources in a central area. And we aren't really going to need space between our builds anymore, because we aren't going to build stuff off to other production areas. However, we are going to need at least a good amount of iron and a good amount of copper. So we will leave in space for four of each, four belts of each. The other lines will just get squished together though, so. I guess we should start making some assembly machines and some logistic robots, which we just need the frames for, which we have stocked up on. Let's make this insert a bit faster, just because I want as many robots as fast as possible. We don't need construction robots, that was a mistake, but we can always just put them into the same area and they can make some of our assembly machines for us. Now when we make these robot assembling areas, general processing areas using robots, I always, the biggest problem with it is always just how do we get the oil in there, but honestly we aren't going to need that much, I hope at least, so our current processing might be enough. We don't need that one. Maybe we should make room for just one more line of green circuits. I guess we'll do that, just to be sure that we have enough of that. It is quite easy to just extend our green setup here instead of having robots hauling these resources around. It is a lot of resource pushing. So we'll expect to process that in the bus and then not have to do it in the robot processing area. I'm not sure if we should actually. I guess we can't really fit it in here anyway, so for now we'll just keep the lines as they were, and then we'll just add the second green belt on top of all these. And let's get these lines cleaned up a bit. And let's get the stone down here as well. So again, usually I use a mod called Warehouse, or Warehousing, I guess. Where I can just unload all of these resources into a couple of warehouses with another mod called Loaders that just ferry a whole belt into whatever you connect it to. But for the sake of continuing our vanilla run, we'll just use chests. Surprise. And we'll make some of these offset of each other. So something like this. I'm not sure if we get red belts, if our fast inserters can handle a full red belt. Maybe they can. I hope so. And this should allow us to use an underground belt. And offload this build as well. Let's just get some power out here. I hate looking at those yellow lights flashing, so for my sanity, let's get power. And honestly, we should get some breakout here as well, but I don't really want to do that right now, so let's wait a bit. So we can't have this line offload here, and actually we should prepare for two more lines of iron as well, which also means that we need two spaces in between these to get more underground belts. So let's redesign this a bit. And that should allow us to put another line of iron out here. I guess we should just copy and paste this. Something like this. And we will need the fourth line out there as well. So let's put that down. We can put that closer, but let's just put it with the same distance between. And let's make some more chests. So let's connect this up, and we do not have space for this because that'll be another processing area for copper here. Did I miss anything? I guess I should place down some power poles again. As then we can just copy paste this whole thing. Oh no, we need another space between these, it seems. So should we actually get another line out here? That is a good question. Let's just do it. I was thinking that we could just put a space in between these, but let's try this instead. I don't want to combine the chests at the bottom. Combine iron with copper, and when we get further up, our blue circuit with electric engines. So this is how we'll do it. Though they aren't connected to any robot ports, of course, but that's okay. Let's just use the copper wire that we had created by error, by a mistake, I guess. Okay, so this should be somewhat copy-pasteable. Now, of course, we have one electric pole that's in the way. So how do we get rid of that? And why is it in the way, and the others aren't? Let's just take this piece for now, get a bit of a closer look. Can we get around that? So on the bottom one, it's just because we don't have a line going into the inserters, of course. Is an easy way to fix this. Let's just paste it for now and let's see if we can do something about it. So maybe this should just be put something like this. And we might as well extend this to its full length. So we should have power to everything now. And just to fill everything up, let's create some balancers here. Like so. And then we'll fill up the whole way. like so, then we have all of our cover. Four lines of that. If we weren't blocking it, of course. Let's see if we can get some RoboPort going. I do not all want all that coal. Of course, a lot of robots will take a lot of power, so we might have to go and expand that at some point. Hopefully we won't need solar power. I mean, we can just live off of steam power. That should be totally doable. Let's just get one more. We need some steel for that. Great. And let's get some more of these put down. So now we have four extra belts that we can populate with whatever we need. And I guess we could expand it as well. Let's not just build a lot up there. For now, at least. Let's put down some robobots. Like so, and let's put in some logistic robots and start crafting some more of them, which requires more red circuits, of course. If we get all of these resources in, then we can start just taking from there instead of waiting for the build. So let's do that, and let's get some more chests crafted. This is a lot of resources, but it should be worthwhile soon. Regarding how much or how little preparation every sort of processing takes. Still need lots of chests, of course, but should be coming. Thank you, Windows. Thank you very much. I thought I just allowed it to update earlier, but I guess it forgot or something. And apparently we are totally out of cover now, because we are putting everything into green circuit production. So we are doing something with it at least, which is great. But we might still need to get a train to get us some more. Or we could just take from this and smelt it in electric furnaces, but I don't really want to use the power on that, so I would rather put up a train. So more chests still. upgrade some of these. I don't want my steel line to be backed up at least. That should always be running. We will need a lot of steel in the long run. And apparently we need some robopods up top as well. So we can get all of the chests in the network. Great. Let's just start with this for now. So, working towards our purple science, let's produce some rail. And for this part, I'll just take an old blueprint book that contains some easy blueprints. And of course, in that blueprint, it's level 3 assembly machines, which I'm not really intending to build now. And we need some requester chests. So this, let's... Is it not shift right click to delete a blueprint anymore? Oh, it's just because I do not have this in my inventory, I guess. So let's get it there. Yeah, okay. No, still nothing. Oh, if I take it from here. There we go. And let's turn it around so we can get power down here. And the robots won't have to travel as far. Let's clear a bit of the area. Not too much for now, but trees annoy me. So, let's start building rail, I guess. And for rail we need iron sticks. One assembly machine should do that job quite nicely. And then rail. One assembly machine should be able to do this as well. Now this machine will need quite a lot of resources, so we will need a lot of robots just for that, to keep it running. That shouldn't be too big of a problem. Let's go get some more robo frames and then we can keep producing these. If we can get some red circuits, of course. Which we have apparently stopped producing because of no cover, of course. Okay. Let's just queue up all of that and let's put down a chest here with semi-junk that we can let the robots take from. What else do we want to put down? There isn't really anything. Let's put down one of these. So, at least we have rail now. And... then we need electric furnaces. Which require brick. Did we get brick in here at some point? Did I really not get brick here? Where's my brick line? Is it just empty? This one? No, that's the red circuits. Where's my brick? Oh, I didn't extend it the full way. That's great. That means we'll have to do some moving around of the resources up there. Or should we just build it under here? Let's just do that, honestly. I do not want to move all these lines up one tile. And we of course have to use a red belt, underground belt, just to get the further reach of that. But at least that should get us some break up. Oh, we can make electric furnaces. I guess we'll save for next episode to go get some cover and just get productivity modules started up here. So, what does a productivity module take? Nothing we do not have already. And we need one for every 3 science packs. And we can fabricate one every 15 seconds. If we create 5 of these, we have one every 3 seconds. Or we could just make 3 and we have one every 5 seconds. That should probably be enough. Honestly, that's probably a bit overkill. Let's not do that. We do have a limited amount of resources, so let's think about that for a bit and just start up our verbal science. So our first purple science should be done soon. And to get it to our science labs, I'm just going to request it over here and put it onto a belt. Easy solutions. Not the prettiest, but I'm not too sad about that for now. When we are this close to our goal of sending over a rocket. Request the science, please. All the science. Of course, we aren't really making any yellow science either, because we have no lightweight. Low density structure, sorry. Might as well be lightweight structure. And we do not have any of that because we have no copper. And that's the name of the game. And of course we need power out here. Let's just make sure that there's room for this. So we do have the yellow signs on the left side of the build, which makes room for the purple signs over here, so that's great. Okay, what signs should we start on for our rockets? We do just need those two, so might as well get them started. And I guess we should replicate this a bunch of times. Of course, we do not have any resources for this anymore, so we will have to go get some more copper soon. Maybe we should do a bit more of these just to actually put them into our machines. Oh, let's not do that. I don't think that we will get any profit from that in the amount of time that we have left in the game. So what else can we get going? What is needed to send up a rocket, I guess we should find out. And we should get some concrete as well. Rocket control units, low density structures and rocket fuel. That should be simple enough. Except that rocket fuel now requires light oil, I guess. But let's get some concrete done first. This requires water as far as I remember. Where is concrete? Here we are. Yeah, water. But we do have a water line coming up here, so that's not a problem. And it requires iron ore, of course. 1 iron ore equals 10 concrete. I think we'll just go and get us 100 or more iron ore, and then just set up a temporary concrete fabrication. And that will allow us to go get our car as well. Which could be handy, as we might get back and forth between the train station and our robot processing facility a lot more often soon. So how fast can I get a couple hundred of these? Very fast, okay. Go away, trees. So let's just put this in here, so our robots has access to it. In what facility is this made? In normal assembly machines. Concrete. What else did it require? Bricks, of course, that's great. We should have all the ray brick we could ever need up here. And we just need the water. Pipes, 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 pipes. Did I put down my pipes somewhere? I think I did. Let's just get these. Actually, let's get some of the more useful resources as well. No reason to have these here. We could put in some less useful resources instead. Plastic, why is the plastic here? Let's get rid of that. These are useful. This is useful. We don't really need one of them for anything in particular. Okay. So let's get this concrete going. Actually, that's all we got time for in this episode. Saying thank you all for joining me, and I'll see you next time. Bye.